commentary spiel. When the show is over, I'll order for Mark's album, Damn Gold. Oh, I'm a singer, loves a singer, so sing along with me as I sing songs.
What is my button to say, sir?
Lady Bird, start packing. The Nixons are coming.
Lady Bird, start packing. The Nixons are coming. If you think this political season is bad, just flashback. Anyway, it's a train wreck out there. I want to thank you all for coming. I know you could have stayed home and watched your 50-inch televisions. And I brought my my GPS with me to help navigate. I'd like to just talk about the 800-pound gorilla in the room first. You, sir, in the back, could you stand up? I'm just kidding. It's my mustache!
Yeah!
For those of you who don't know me, I normally don't have a mustache, but I did it as a favor for people who I might make out with later, because have you ever kissed anyone with facial hair? You can taste and tell what they had to eat the day prior to kissing them. Breakfast could be bagels and lox, lunch tuna melt, and dinner is something Asian, I don't know, but there's soy. You can definitely taste soy. It's great to be here at Sid Gold, and they have food here, and they actually have a political sandwich. It's the Trump sandwich. It's white bread, bologna, Russian dressing, no tax, and comes with a small pickle. So, I don't know, it's not selling very well. It's great to see all of you here. I see some old faces and some new faces and some fellow performers, and us fellow performers, you know, we could be out every single night of the week seeing some of our other fellow performer friends. So I really appreciate you coming out. But most of all, I'm seeing a lot of flaws. Lots and lots of flaws. All around me are familiar faces, worn out faces, worn out faces. We all perform in the same old places, going nowhere, going nowhere. I got the vivid end of my first solo show, so sit and listen, sit and listen. The clock is ticking, this is, hold on. I've got to go back to my GPS. All right. Room, so I've been here a while. I crawled here in diapers in 1979. It's just not the same city that it used to be. It used to be alive and fun and vibrant and dangerous. I mean, it's still alive and fun, but not so dangerous. Not unless you consider overheated, disgruntled Tickle Me Elmo in Times Square dangerous. So. Not really. It belongs to the millennials right now, with their marketing and branding, and we're losing our brick and mortar gothic buildings to be torn down for these shoeboxes in the sky, these soulless pop-up hotels like across the street, the Marriott Inn, Marriott Garden Inn, Holiday Inn Express, and Doubletree Inn. Well, thank you, Rudy Giuliani and Mayor Bloomberg. So, this song's for you. Again. Okay, we'll just pick it right up. of 911. We got a mayor about this high. We are New Yorkers. Yes, we are. In a generation of all. We are the ones he left behind. And I wonder if it will ever be understood. Oh. Living under the fear of corporate neighborhoods. We don't need another Starbucks. We don't need another CVS. We don't need another bank branch. This is my home. Yeah. My home. Woo. Woo. Looking for some place. Doesn't look all the same. Oh, my shoes are too tight. My feet are in pain. No more CBGBs. No more restaurant for all. Just luxury high rising in the sky. Saying we don't need another Starbucks, we don't need another CVS, we don't need another bank branch. This is my home, my turf, my hood. Whoa, thank you. The late great city of New York. Well, it's been a rough year. My cat died, I got a DWI. Selection cycle is like a train wreck. I can't just look away. What I like to do to distract myself is watch certain reality shows with real stories, like this one called I Survived. It's about people who are lost at sea or who have been kidnapped by Scientologists, and they always say what got them through was they were just thinking of their family and how they wanted to get back home to them. And I thought to myself, I would never make it if that was never survive. Let me tell you something. My home consists of my mother and sister living together. It's kind of like Grey Gardens meets Who's Afraid of Virginia Woolf meets Whatever Happened to Baby Jane meets The Exorcist. A typical phone call from my mother can go like this. David, your sister just called me a crazy fucking bitch. Here, you talk to her. Carol, hi. Please don't call our mother a crazy fucking bitch. She may be crazy, and she may be a bitch, but she's not fucking, and if she is, I don't want to know about it! Yeah. I just wanted to get away. I wanted to get away this summer. Using frequent flyer miles. And I did. Well, I didn't get away, but I looked into it. And I was going to visit my friend in Amsterdam, and, flying to Amsterdam, there were no direct flights on this carrier, so it was a layover in London Heathrow, and it was going to be $300 in taxes and fees. I said, fuck that. So I looked into a partner carrier, and it flew to Dusseldorf, which was 2.5 hours away, and that was $5. I said, I'm in. So I had to look for public transportation to get from Dusseldorf to Amsterdam, and in researching, I found this site called Blah Blah Car. It's real, Blah Blah Car, and it's a website where people who have cars can look up and hook up with passengers and get paid to drive them from point A to point B. So, and if you're a passenger, you find someone with a Blah Blah Car. So, I didn't get to Europe, but I wrote a song about Blah Blah Car. get into a stranger's car. Cue that Euro trash disco track. I'm just another guy adding up a sum. I need to find a reason why I want to feel alive. I need to get outside. I want to take a ride. Can you pick me up in your baba car? Drive me crazy, but not too far. Super uba buda ba. Dashboard is alive. I'm looking in your headlights. Fuel runs between my thighs. What a fun surprise. Now shift the gear to five. Can you pick me up in your blah blah car? Drive me crazy, but not too far. Super Koopa Boonaba. Yes, steady bizarre. Can you pick me up in your blah blah car? From I don't care to when we get there, we'll grab a drink at the Nowhere Bar. Where you going? I'm alone. There's heavy traffic. Let's hit the road. I'm driving on the left. I feel a bit bereft. I could use a little danger. We've got lots of time, so tell me something stranger. Can you pick me up in your baba car? Drive me crazy, but not too far. Suba, uba, bundaba. Destiny bizarre. Can you pick me up in your baba car? From I don't care to la la. When we get there, we'll grab a drink. Tell me there was heroin and hash in the glove compartment. Thank you. Wouldn't that be great if we had our own glove on top? We should have that here. Your narcissism is exhausting me. Every time I turn around, you post a new selfie. You and a hashtag helps us find you, but all I know about you is that you're always posting your hearts will float and feed you, and your history will keep you. But I'm here to remind you, you never think of me. Your Twitter account amounts to nothing for me. Nobody cares about your stupid. And I visited your website, and your video is real tight, and your YouTube makes me wanna fight my own lethargy. And I may be singing to you, and the song may be about you, 'cause of course it is, it ought to, it's a gift from me. You watch a concert through a 3-inch screen. You'll never view again or post to be seen. You Google search yourself from A to Z. Turns out you're related to a chimpanzee. Where did you go? What did you buy? Who were you with? Where was I? What did you do? I wonder why. Someone we know has just died. Don't you wanna cry? You're too busy posting your own philosophies to tear yourself away from your computer screen. Your narcissism is exhausting me. You're like a parakeet in the mirror. Shut the fuck up. I can't believe it. It's outrageous. It's outrageous. Some friend. I love it when people tell me that they were unfriended by someone. I don't know. I just think it's so ridiculous. I get a kick out of it. I don't know. You gotta get this stuff out. It'll give you cancer if you don't. Or at the very least, hemorrhoids. And you don't want an intimate visitor going down there and finding a busted ravioli. Does anyone need a Twitter or an Instagram break? Just let it keep you on your... this young generation, I don't know. They don't like to interact. They don't really talk. They're humorless. They don't look you in the eye, and they don't like to be touched. Of course, I'm talking about three-year-olds, but and they smell like pee and candy. It's not worth it. I thought it would be interesting to do a section of songs that kind of drive me crazy, that I find annoying, or make me depressed, or that I just straight up hate. It's my hate medley, and I want to talk about the song Shiny Happy People. Now, I know and have met both of these people. One I've known for quite a while, pretty long, and the other one, yeah, not so much. One of them is definitely shiny and definitely happy, and yeah, the other one, yeah, not so much. Shiny, happy people holding hands.
Shiny, happy people loving.
People look around. People look your love around. Love me, next. Say so much, no, they don't. Sometimes when we touch, the honesty is too much, and I have to close my eyes and hide. I wanna hold you till I die. Can we both? I wanna hold you till the fear in me subsides. Move it along, you pussy. And the nuts and the pale and the sillies. Little boy blue and the man in the moon. When you're coming home, Dad, I don't know when. We'll get together then, son. You know we'll have a good time then. Yeah, sounds like a riot.
The people
know it. I love LA.
We love it.
I love LA.
We love
no,
it.
No, we don't. Legend lives on Pontiac. The big lake they call it Chagumi. Lake it is said it never gives up her dead. When the skies of November turn blue, it just tell me I'm from Michigan.
Oh, Blackwater, keep on rolling. Mississippi, you won't keep on shining. Oh, Blackwater, keep on rolling. This dip and boo won't keep on chiming on me.
Not you, you dirty hillbilly.
Learn the truth. Life was meant for beauty queens. High school girls with pale-skinned smiles. Married young and then retired.
Get me a noose. You don't know me, but I'm your brother. I was raised here in this living hell. You don't know.
One thing in mind.
it with my selfie stick. Taking dick pics high and low. Taking a dick pic and I wanna show ya. Lonely ponies gonna take a dick pic. Lonely ponies taking dick pics. Lonely ponies gonna take a dick pic. Sticking my dick into your eye. Taking dick pics.
Love of my new heart.
or maybe too soft.